Good afternoon, everyone. It is a pleasure to be here in Brazil, in Porto Alegre, a city where, with a very special and historic significance for social movements and global justice, and also to be here at the Pontificia Universidade Católica do Rio Grande do Sul, who hosted me for the first time as part of the International Committee of the First World Social Forum, which occurred in this same place 20 years ago. I'm old, you know. Before starting this reading, I would like to thank the effort made by my dear friends Augusto Jobim and Fernanda Martins so that I can be here with you today. I would like also to thank Professor Ruth Gauer and the entire teaching and technical team of the university, Regina, friends, as well as the students, my dear students of the law school and the postgraduate program in criminal sciences. As Professor Donna Haraway defends, making comunidade is the only way to survive in this world. I think encounters like these are a wonderful way to strengthen this kind of kin. So welcome. This lecture is an approach to my recent research works at the Center for Social Studies of the University of Coimbra, the research group on political communication of the University of Seville in Spain. Thank you very much.
Welcome.
Muito obrigado. And the International Consortium Tecnopoliticas, you can check the link and the site, is dedicated to the loving memory of my dear friend and colleague Britta Baumgarten, a German sociologist of the University Institute in Lisbon, who have passed away in October last year. Dr. Baumgarten work on the Portuguese social movements of the last decade is essential to understand a part of my own work. I invite all of you to read and discover it, encouraging you to participate with your research articles in the annual prize dedicated to honor her loving memory. So let's go. In the current context of the crisis of representation and formal democracy, and in the face of the spread of populist movements and the social challenges of building inclusive societies grounded in equality and the respect for diversity and differences, the commitment to human rights and democracy are both central aspects understood in terms of citizen participation in the creation of institutions and a political agenda based on knowledge and social innovation, which I term as a commons-based democracy, a democracy based in commons, in common goods. Information and communication technologies are strategic elements when attempting to understand the upsurge of these movements, highlighting the impact of internet social media and private internet messenger services like Telegram, WhatsApp, you know, in public awareness on the basis of a new and practically virgin academic scientific field, technopolitics, defined here as the appropriation of information and communication technologies, internet social media, private internet message services by social movements for political purposes, and the impact that this is having on the institutional sphere in the technological transition, not only with respect to election campaigns and political agendas, but also as a strategic dimension when researching into the very representation, identity, and culture of these movements and their influence on the public sphere. The debate around social movements has moved on from recognition, identity, and organization in the 80s to the analysis of communication as a strategic dimension, breaking with research focus on leveraging resources, American functionalism, and so to delve deeper into the technopolitical dimension, which has opened up a new path for research into social movements. Since the end of the last decade, the increase in the mass use of transmedia narratives linked to the development of the connectography of multiple and hybrid cross-media platforms and networks has subsumed the traditional communication flow of the media, individually consumed as a sort of collective media, individually consumed and a narrative constantly created by prosumers all of us, generating an enormous contingent of data, big data, seen currently as a strategic source to be mined, data mining, data mining, across the use of algorithms in politics, and the creation of which I call algoritarism, as an expression of the rise of a new global authoritarianism, digitally expressed and mediated. In Europe, these mentioned processes underscore how the passive role of citizens has been transformed by introducing a proactive dimension, characterized by participation and even by the possibility of updating established politics, by actively contributing to create new political agendas. In this regard, worthy of mention are political projects as Podemos, Demo Local 4.0, and the initiatives of Opencratio in Spain, those of Geração Arrasca in Portugal, the impact of leaks, of recent leaks, and also so recent, those of WikiLeaks or Edward Snowden leaks and Bradley Manning, if you remember these cases, and the influence of information and communication technologies and transmedia and cross-media dimensions on election campaigns, as Obama machine 2.0, and highlighting the last US presidential elections with the alleged involvement of Russia-backed hackers in boycotting Clinton's run for the White House. The widespread availability of internet social media outlets in Europe is modifying our social and political perceptions, attitudes, relations, and cognitions, paradoxically fanning the flames of nationalism and populism as a direct consequence of the boomerang effect in which the member states of the European Union are seen as fenders against European Union politics and vice versa. This situation has been compounded by the problems to consolidate an European public sphere, such as the Juncker Commission's priorities relating to security states and the promotion of common values of freedom, tolerance, human rights, and democracy beyond the success of any shared experiences and memories of a small number of European Union citizens through effective European Union policy making, highlighting the key role that information and communication technologies and internet social media play in interactions among institutions, the citizenry, social movements, and public awareness against national media as a traditional and hegemonic area of Europeanization. The relationship between both processes, on the one hand, the institutional representation and representative democracy crisis, and on the other, the prosumer boom of the internet, together with the drastic cutbacks and the austerity policies adopted by authorities, which have been dubbed as undemocratic and opaque by public opinion to combat the economic crisis since 2008, have transformed the traditional media ecosystem in the European Union, shifting the agenda towards these new communication spheres and leading to a gradually higher level of Euroscepticism. The building of an anti-European public opinion expressed through this new sphere and present in the discourses of organization and populist parties that began to emerge in the context of the crisis of 2008, such as the Movimento Cinque Stelle in Italy, UK Independence Party, UKIP, which has ultimately led to the Brexit campaign and the UK withdrawal from the European Union, or the rise of far-right parties, linked through international alt-right think tanks, like the movement of Steve Bannon, but not so, are challenges that contrast with the lack of inquiry into a knowledge of the influence that information and communication technologies have on these processes from a technopolitical perspective. An aspect that cannot be properly understood without extensive transdisciplinary research still pending in Europe, and I can imagine that here in Brazil too, but I don't know, I really don't know. the spreading of globalization and the information society have made possible the development of new forms of online participation, exchange of social knowledge, learning experiences, and activism in a wired world. Until the increase of European academic influence of new social movement theory of the 80s, and their cultural and identity-based interpretation developed by scholars as Alain Touré and Jürgen Habermas and Alberto Melucci, among others, and the critics to this approach made by Jean Cohen, Klaus Offe, and Klaus Eder, the North American sociology contributions, basically the resources mobilization, political opportunity processes, and rational choice approaches, to build up a paradigm on social movements, targeted structural and behavioral elements in their studies as the dominant understanding. From then on, diverse theories emerged, such as the models proposed by Melucci, Diani, and Donatella della Porta, stressing the concept of network. After the appearance in 2001 of the World Social Forum, here, where we are exactly, was in this building, as a network of networks of social movements. This concept has been widely applied to innovative analysis of global movement against hegemonic globalization across the breaking work of Boaventura de Sousa Santos, for example, highlighting the central role of my idea of a commons-based democracy as the social relations aim to a good living and the construction of new common senses that runs through the new politics of social movements as a new epistemology, which is a tentative to overcome the gap produced by the so-called epistemic asymmetry denounced by Evgeny Morozov. Paradigmatically, the link among public and privatized bodies, the critical networks, and related to the appropriation of technology as politics of human rights in the age of the internet, social media. Social movements that have emerged in the context of the economic crisis, defined in other work of mine as recent global social movements, and which are calling for real democracy, real participation in a real democracy, have had a considerable impact on the European Union, above all in Southern Europe, underlying the case of Portuguese Movimiento 12 de Marzo and the Spanish Movimiento 15M, 15 de Mayo. These movements have contributed to spread a conception of a commons-based democracy, focused in the sphere of the city and the local politics with results in local elections, e.g. Barcelona en Comú, for example, and Madrid Ahora in Spain, which emphasizes its social dimension, self-government, on the basis of a decision-making capacity, deliberation, and participation. Over the past few decades, the European Union has dealt with the possibilities for the existence of a public sphere, often Lichkeit, in a post-Westphalian and post-national Europe, Habermas, and their critics, especially from feminist theory, Saskia Sassen and Nancy Fraser, among others. The European refugee crisis and migratory policies have redefined these possibilities in the agenda of organizations and political parties, especially after the war in Syria or during the war in Syria, in which a return to nationalism has marked a turning point that should be taken into account. In Italy, for example, with Lega and Movimento Cinque Stelle, and the policies developed by the Minister Salvini, for example. Research into the relationship between information and communication technologies and politics and social movements began in the middle of the last decade by analyzing the activity of bloggers and websites, while the first tentative approach to the potential political uses of Facebook was made a decade later. Even though they offered comparative and complementary perspectives to critical discourse analysis, these research projects have regarded discourse as a general social phenomenon rather than investigating particular linguistic patterns in political discourse, or directly studying it as an expression of public opinion on internet social media, which is one of my innovative contributions of my proposal. The privatization processes imposed by neoliberalism against the context of the capitalism global crisis generated in 2008 have caused the emergence of resistance collective demonstrations inscribed in a new cycle of protests and mobilizations in the global scale. In every case, from Tunisia to the United States of America, Turkey to Brazil, Greece, Portugal, or Spain, among other geographies, collective action in public space has been intensified, giving rise to diverse forms of politicization from below, related to shared social struggles and developed mainly in local and national scopes, but linked globally over the internet. Since 2011, diverse social movements have come forward in different parts of the world against the background of the global crisis. The uses of information and communication technologies, internet, social media, and private internet message services made by movements has opened new paths and setting up new challenges, not only for scientific research, but for social, political, and economic organizations in our changing world. It is noteworthy the impact in the European Union of those social movements that have come up in some countries of Southern Europe. And its influences and links with other movements appear thereafter in the Union and abroad, like Brazil, Mexico, Colombia, Occupy Wall Street, United States, for example. In 2009, the European Union conferred the Charter of Fundamental Rights a status of primary law by including it in the Treaty of Lisbon, seeking to create a more democratic and transparent Europe of human rights and values, freedom, solidarity, and security. The chapter stipulates the whole range of civil, political, economic, and social human rights recognized for European citizens and residents. Nevertheless, the above-mentioned social movements, henceforth designated as recent global social movements, are still claiming for a direct participation in what they call a real democracy. Moreover, 2013 was declared by the European Union the European Year of Citizens, dedicated to the rights that come up with the European Union citizenship, with the aim to encouraging dialogue between all levels of government, civil society, and business, to discuss those European rights and build a vision of how the European Union should be in 2020, as a state, its institutional declaration. Horizon 2020 work program states, quote, "Europe's crisis has triggered a renewed European-wide debate on the future of European integration and the political system of the European Union, and the notion of the European Union's democratic deficit seems to be confirmed." End of the quote. In Spain, also in 2013, the European Court of Justice sentenced the Spanish Supreme and Eviction Law, as well as the European Parliament awarded as Citizen of the Year the Plataforma de Afectados por la Hipoteca, or platform of those affected by the subprime mortgage crisis, one of these recent global social movements, recognizing the importance of these social processes to public awareness of democracy and human rights in the European Union. Again, the epistemic asymmetry. It is noteworthy the impact that in the European Union of those social movements that have come up in some countries of Southern Europe, and its influences and links with other movements appeared thereafter in the Union and abroad, that are still claiming for a direct participation in a real democracy, as I have remarked. Social movements have contributed recently to expand and update a commons-based conception of democracy, highlighting the recent global role of the feminist and ecologist movements. in Spain, the Spanish municipal elections of 2015 have pointed out the importance of a commons-based democracy, not only in the electoral programs of the new political organizations, which discourses, narratives, identities, and even front persons are closely linked with social movements above mentioned. But with the strategic information and communication technologies, internet, social media, and private internet message services, uses intertwined with a commons-based democratic epistemology that configures these social movements as recent global social movements, a new epistemic category. A specific question in the Spanish case is the displacement of an important part of this form of politicization to the electoral field, where the political cycle that begins with the emergence of 15M movement in May 2011 has permitted the aperture of a space for action out of the traditional bipartisan system with the Partido Popular, the far right party, and the Partido Socialista Obrero Español, left social democrat left party. These processes have propitiated the appearance of new political parties as electoral platforms at national scope, as Partido X, Partido X, Podemos, or Unidos Podemos, Unidas Podemos, the electoral coalition between Podemos, Izquierda Unida, Equo, and other leftist forces. While at local scope, the protest cycle has crystallized in the formation of citizen municipal candidatures, which in the municipal election of 24 May 2015 have obtained notable achievements in the medium and largest cities as Barcelona, Madrid, Malaga, Cádiz, Zaragoza, Sevilla, and others, among others, taking into account the recent rise of the far right forces, which is a recent problem there. The recent global social movements emerged in Portugal and Spain since 2011 contribute to create collective practice and founding spaces for a commons-based democracy as a political principle able to generate high-intensity democratic experience, such as listening, assembly, and consensus behaviors, as well as collective behaviors of socialization in which people support and coordinate themselves daily in order to stop evictions, to defend public health from privatization, to denounce scratches, banks and politicians who are made responsible for the crisis. A new space of social interrelation that escapes from the legal and political hegemonic limits of the public and the private is being built from common action. But it's not only about building new narratives, a new lexicon, or it would be better said, a new counter-hegemonic hypertextuality. This auto-communicative praxis is, by the way, a self-organizing praxis constant that questions the whole system and the cultural, economic, legal, social, and political order that has established it, and thus defining not only this new space, but also new rhythms, new complex temporalities, plural and heterogeneous, eclectic, horizontal, of course, according to new forms of production of politics. These new perceptions of ourselves and especially of the others, with the others, influence directly in an active, offensive, participative, and co-responsible conception of democracy and citizenry, in a common pedagogy that transcends the linearity of electoral periods and fiscal years, instituting the complex time of deliberation, interpretation, participation, and decision making without delegation. Therefore, it is also a substantive issue related to new ways of conceiving the commons-based democracy, politics, and institutions from the deliberative, from the deliberative and participatory democratic radicalism, questioning horizontally and corresponsively the principles of equality and distribution of the political power from the material to the immaterial. Just a minute. Think only that everyone has a smartphone in the pocket. Only this. You can see this picture, but think that everyone can be supervised, localized. The underlying social learnings of the institutional transformation show in this paradigm the capabilities of these southern movements bids to rise critically alternatives to the established, challenging the limits and the willingness to take risks in the passage through the recognitions of the limits to the possibility of affecting changes in the institutions, framing the adoption of other values and other practices. Thank you very much.